Greg, we won't know the results of the U.S. midterm elections until November 8th. But let's talk about what Canadians should be paying attention to, our two economies so tied closely together.
I think there's a real interesting angle in our elections on energy, which, of course, is a big, big deal for Canadians. I think that there's an increasing chance that the Republicans will recapture the House. The Senate may stay Democratic. That's been a shift in the last few weeks. But I think the House will flip back to the Republicans, who I think would be much more conservative on energy, would be much more favorably inclined toward oil, coal, and natural gas.
Let's get into some of that. Let's get into the policies, the bills, the acts. You mentioned energy. Let's talk about the climate bill. Let's get into the Inflation Reduction Act. Specifically, what should we be watching for on this side of the divide?
I think there's been a change of attitudes in the U.S. toward energy because of shortages. I think that the White House realizes that high gasoline prices is a bigger deal for them than the environmental issues. So I think there will be a push by several members of Congress to do more on pipelines. I think there'll be an effort to do that. And I think there'll be an effort to be more accommodative toward energy refining. Those are two big issues where I think U.S. policy will shift.
Now, we saw this narrative of competitiveness in the U.S. Dominating that landscape. The Biden administration, of course, with the Build Back Better and Buy American. Is that still the agenda there?
It's still the agenda, but I think that this really alarming surge of inflation has changed the narrative dramatically. I think inflation is now the number one issue. It's going to lead to aggressive interest rate tightening by the Federal Reserve. They're nowhere close to being finished on tightening. And I think because of inflation, we see a different attitude on things like Build Back Better. In retrospect, we probably spent too much money after COVID, after the recession. And I think Build Back Better is going to be a negative for the overall economy because of the amount of money we're spending.
Greg, you mentioned that inflation continues to dominate those conversations. What does the U.S. president have to do ahead of the midterms? What conversations does he need to have to address inflation?
Well, it's a good question. And I would say, Larysa, first and foremost, he needs to let the Federal Reserve do the job. And the Fed's going to be aggressive. We're going to see more interest rate increases over the next few weeks and months. Secondly, I think he has to emphasize energy and try to get prices down. Ukraine is part of that narrative. I think that Biden will give more aid to the Ukrainians. This is a great story to see the Russian troops being pushed out. But I'd say first and foremost, Biden has to resist dramatic new spending. One of the reasons why inflation is high in the U.S. is that we spent too much money.
You had mentioned what Congress might look like. 435 seats up for grabs in the House, 35 of the 100 in the Senate, and 36 of 50 states could see new governors. Does this mean that Canada will have to cultivate new relationships, given that maybe some of the old relationships are on their way out?
Well, first and foremost, I'd say, Larysa, that the relations between Joe Biden and Trudeau are quite good. And I don't see that changing at all. I think Justin Trudeau is quite popular in Washington, but there will be a different look to the next Congress. I think it'll be more conservative. I think it will be more anti-regulation. And I think that will perhaps distinguish the two countries. I could see this new Congress being a lot tougher on energy policy in particular.
Of course, all of this culminates with the presidential election in 2024. Yeah. Given all of the recent events surrounding Donald Trump, how do you see this road to that election in 2 years playing out?
Well, he remains extremely controversial. He's got a lot of legal issues, but Donald Trump is brilliant at stalling, at delaying, appealing to courts. A lot of court cases surrounding him have dragged on for years, and he may do that again with these documents that were found in Mar-a-Lago. He may do that with the January 6th issue. So I think there still is a path for Trump to run for president. He has tremendous support within his own base. But, and this is a very big but, I think more and more Republicans, especially in Washington, are sick of him. I think they would rather have someone else. And there is someone else who I think will be a very big player. That's the governor of Florida, Ron DeSantis, who I think is going to run after he wins his reelection in Florida.